I, Mike Leonard of the Board of Governors of Sir Sanford Fleming College, declare this 2019 convocation officially open.
Is that for me or Mike? Good morning and welcome. It gives me great pleasure to invite Ashley Savard, Indigenous Student Services Coordinator, to bring a tribute to the graduating students from the First Nations community. Ashley?
Please be seated. Ani Bojo Sego. Hello, everyone. My name is Ashley Safar. I'm the Indigenous Student Service Coordinator here at Fleming College. I am Wolf Clan and a member of Tandanega First Nation. For those of you who may not be aware, it is in our teachings that as settlers and or visitors to this territory, we must first introduce ourselves in order to share who we are, where we come from, and our intentions for being here today. It is also a sign of respect to open with an acknowledgement of the territory in which we stand upon. Therefore, on behalf of all of us here today, I would like to say Chimigwech, thank you to the Mississauga people for allowing us to continue to work, live, and in this case study, within the territory and the negotiated treaty lands of the Williams Treaty and Treaty Number 20. Today, you'll notice that graduates may be wearing a medicine wheel pin on their gowns. These students have chosen to make a declaration that they will carry with them beyond the walls of Fleming College. Students wearing these pins have made a declaration to move forward in their professional and personal lives as people who not only acknowledge the rights of Indigenous peoples, but will be respectful allies to First Nations, Métis, and Inuit peoples within the territory that they choose to call home. On behalf of Fleming College, I would like to say Chimigwech for being an active participant in the work towards reconciliation. And guests, we ask that you honor these students by giving them a round of applause. On behalf of Indigenous Student Services and the Fleming Indigenous Education Council, Miigwech, Nyawe, and congratulations. We wish you success in your future endeavors. I would also like to introduce you to Nimki Ozwamik. Nimki is Odawa Potawatomi from Wukwemekong Unceded First Nation on Manitoulin Island and is a member of the Wolf Clan. Nimki will be offering a song to honor today's graduates. Please remove your hats and stand for the honor song. Miigwech.
Yeah, 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 y
Thank you, Mimi Laswanwick. I'd also like to thank Ashley Safar and Piper Glenn McDonald. I would now like to ask Dan Bronson to come forward. He's right here, I see, and lead us in singing the national anthem. Please be seated. Thank you, Dan Bronson. You know, if our famous Scottish namesake, Sir Sandford Fleming, were here with us today, I'm sure he would say something like, "Aye, isn't this just grand?" Once again, welcome. My name's Alex Smith, and I am your MC for today's ceremony. My responsibility is to ensure that this very special occasion runs smoothly and with the dignity and respect deserved to each graduating student. I also should mention that I know this ceremony is live streamed, so I'd like to welcome those people that can't be here and are watching the ceremony. Today, we will be recognizing the academic achievements of our students in the following programs: biotechnology, advanced esthetician, fitness and health promotion, health information management, pharmacy technician, occupational therapist assistant and physiotherapist assistant, recreation and leisure services, and therapeutic recreation. First, some housekeeping information for you. There is staff present on the floor and in the auditorium to provide assistance, and we do have staff present to provide emergency first aid if it's needed. The ceremony will be about 1.5 hours in length, and we would ask that all graduates remain in the auditorium for the duration of the ceremony to respect each graduate as they receive their collar and diploma. Catherine Fairbanks will be our ASL English interpreter, and during the presentation she will be located at the right of the podium. Everyone's invited to a reception at the Kawartha Trades and Technology Centre immediately following the ceremony, and gowns are also available at the reception should you wish to take photos. Golf carts will be also available to take you over there. On behalf of our school, I would quickly like to thank the college registrar staff, especially Mark McGee. I call her the general of convocation, and Sheila McGrath and all the staff that help for all their efforts in the preparation of today's ceremony. Also, a significant person in your academic experience here at Fleming has been your program coordinator, and I would like them acknowledged today by asking them to stand and be recognized. I assume you will be noisy when they do. Please stand, program coordinators. Hello. A couple of people you probably haven't seen a lot of in terms of your classrooms is our dean, Carol Kelsey. I call her our super dean. She looks after two schools. And you'll meet her in the podium. She'll be helping with the Calder presentation. I'd also like to mention our chair. He's the person that makes sure we have teachers in all the classrooms and many other things. Nick Stone. Carol and Nick, could you stand so they know who you are? Let's give them a hand. Thank you. I now have the great pleasure of inviting Mike Leonard to bring greetings on behalf of the Board of Governors, followed by remarks from College President Maureen Adamson. Mike.
Thank you. Good morning, graduates, family, friends, and platform guests. Greetings and welcome on behalf of the Fleming College Board of Governors. My name is Mike Leonard, and I'm very happy to be here today celebrating the tremendous accomplishments of our graduates. I would like to extend my most sincere congratulations to all. You graduates are the heart of the community. There is not a sector in our regional economy that is untouched by Fleming students or its graduates. Graduation is a time of celebration, reflection, and excitement. We celebrate the incredible achievements you have accomplished during your time here at Fleming. We reflect on the friendships and connections you have made and the journey you have just completed. And we acknowledge what is next for you to come as you head down whichever path you decide to choose. Today we are celebrating over 300 graduates from various programs within the School of Health and Wellness, Arts and Heritage, and Halliburton School of Art and Design. You are now all qualified and skilled graduates with the tools you need to do great things. Thank you for allowing us to be part of your journey. We look forward to seeing you prosper in the years ahead. And once again, congratulations.
Good morning. Hello and welcome to our platform guests, to family, friends, and of course, our fabulous graduates. I want to just take a moment, it's such an important day, just to take it all in and look around the room. And I wonder if you see what I see. I see family, I see friends, I see partners, neighbors, community. It's those who made dreams come true. Because let's face it, no one can do it alone. And it really does take a village. So graduates, I'd ask you to stand, if you would please. You're going to be sitting a lot. And I'd ask you to turn around and give a very warm round of applause to all those people that helped you get here. Thank you. And then, of course, there is you. Our graduates, we are so excited to recognize and applaud the many accomplishments of this 2019 graduating classes, all of the many that are here with us today. And we have with us graduates from a diverse set of programs, and there is such richness in the different areas of study. Your different histories, your different journeys, and yet you have all found your way here to Fleming College. You've achieved a great deal during your time here at Fleming, and you have left a footprint here for us, because this Fleming is our Fleming. You're a graduate today, an innovative and creative community builder tomorrow, and perhaps most importantly, an integral member of our Fleming community. And yes, there's lots to acknowledge and lots is going on, and we often hear a great deal about artificial intelligence, and it's here and it's disruptive. And knowing that technological and societal change is occurring at a rapid pace, we must not lose sight of what is most important to us as a community. A community that is rich in social consciousness, health and wellness, soft skills, and most importantly, is committed to doing what is right for now and the future. You, graduates, are shaping our world and our community around us. It is you who will develop the best practices of care for the people that we love. It is you who will protect our rich history and our environment, and you will build our future DNA. And you will teach us new creative ways to communicate our civic responsibilities in all of these arenas. They are fundamental to our national society. And countries and economies all around the world recognize the importance of these values and the critical thinking skills that you bring. Now, more than ever, our communities and the rest of the world need your uniquely qualified skills. The importance of what you do is second to none. As you move on to your next exciting chapter, never forget that you are part of our Fleming and our future. And I know change can be scary, but it isn't supposed to be. In fact, it is probably the most consistent aspect of our lives. And I should take another moment to talk about some of the change leaders here, in the room, faculty, staff, parents, friends, and community. You are change leaders. Now, graduates, go out there and make us more proud. Our hand is always on your shoulder. Congratulations.
Thank you, Mike Leonard of the Board of Governors and College President Maureen Adamson. I'm now very pleased to now invite Laura McFarland, graduate of the Biotechnology Advanced Program in 2011, to bring greetings on behalf of the Advancement and Alumni Relations.
Good morning. On behalf of the Fleming Alumni Relations, and as a proud Fleming graduate myself, I would like to welcome you to a very strong, diverse network of more than 75,000 Fleming College graduates. It is my privilege to be part of the celebration of our class of 2019. The alumni network that you and I are now part of is more than just a group of people who graduated Fleming over the past 52 years. We are what Fleming College instilled in us as students. We dare to dream. We continuously expand our knowledge and skills. We develop ourselves along with others. We create learning communities. We are inventive, and we build a better future. Having traits that mirror our namesake, Sir Sanford Fleming, is how we have become and continue to become the best individuals we can be, both personally and professionally. And because Fleming has provided its graduates with such an incredible foundation of skills for success ahead, the alumni network that you and I belong to is inspiring. Don't be intimidated by the many successful grads ahead of you. Instead, take the opportunity to become one yourself. 75,000 graduates have started out exactly where you are now, waiting very patiently to cross the stage, not knowing when their path will look like ahead. As your Fleming experience taught you, dare to dream. As you pursue your career aspirations, I encourage you to maintain the relationship you develop during with what many alumni say were the most powerful, impacting, and rewarding years of their lives. Once you accept your diploma or certificate today, you will be rewarded with a Fleming alumni pin. When life gets busy, it will be your little reminder to stay connected and remember good times at Fleming. In the next month, you will also receive an email from your Fleming College email account. This will be from the Fleming Alumni Relations Department. The email will contain important information about the benefits and perks available to you as alumni, so please look out for this. Class of 2019, you have worked hard to complete your studies and leave Fleming. But make a note, Fleming is not leaving you. It is now rooted in you, and as Fleming alumni, you are now connected forever. Congratulations, graduates. Today marks the day that you continued your journey and all Fleming gave you to become the very best version of yourself. Cheers to your success.
Thank you, Laura. Now, it gives me great pleasure to invite Patricia Hughes, Program Coordinator, Health Information Management, to introduce your valedictorian. Mike Leonard will make a presentation to the valedictorian from the Board of Governors. Patricia?
Well, I think all the graduates today would acknowledge that they have been challenged during their time at Fleming. For students who come to Canada to study, the challenge is even greater. I think learning in another language must be a little bit terrifying. Most of us have enough trouble learning in our own language. From the beginning, Dharav was an engaged and enthusiastic student. He already had a Bachelor of Technology in Biomedical Engineering from Ganpat University in India. After graduation, he worked as a medical records reviewer for an American company, and that was when he decided that his future was in health information management. During his time at Fleming, Dharav exceeded academically and also took advantage of the many courses available to students outside of one's program to help improve them for both their personal and professional lives. Dharav has always conducted himself professionally, both with his peers and his instructors. During his placements in the hospital, he took advantage of every opportunity to hone his skills and increase his confidence. In fact, I think by the time he was through, he felt he really did know what he was doing. During this past semester, Dharav talked to me about an assignment in one of my courses. He told me that he'd really enjoyed doing it because it took him out of his comfort zone, but he now saw how he was able to use his HIM background to improve patient care. He said it was really a fun assignment. Well, as instructors, we don't usually get told that our assignments are fun. Students usually have other words for them. It is my privilege to introduce a graduate from the Health Information Management Program, Dharav Pandya, to give the valedictory. Dharav.
Thank you, Patricia, for your kind words. Respected President of Fleming College, Maureen Adamson, the respected Board of Governors, Deans, designated faculty members, family, friends, and above all, my fellow graduates from the School of Health and Wellness and Arts and Heritage, Haliburton School of Art and Design. Hello and namaste. My name is Dharav Pandya, and I welcome you all to the 52nd convocation ceremony of Sir Sanford Fleming College. This is a great honor for me, and I'm privileged to be standing here addressing all my classmates for one final time before we graduate. I'm excited because I'm proudly the first valedictorian in my family. I'm thrilled, absolutely honored, and I would like to share something with everyone. 2 years ago, I traveled 11,000 kilometers away from my hometown in India, leaving my family, my friends, my job, and most importantly, my comfort zone behind. All I wanted was to study and broaden the boundaries of my knowledge. After arriving here, my life changed completely, right from renting, signing a lease, breakfast, dinner, laundry, finding work, school, and missing my family. Everything landed right at the same time. I was precipitated into a conflict of preserving my own values versus being a part of a new culture. Although it was like a cultural shock initially, it all eased down to normal. Thanks to my classmates for being extremely warm and close to me, to the faculties for being supportive and open-minded, and to the Fleming College in its entirety for providing this campus that is open to the diversity of all colors. A campus that is safe and supports all the educational needs of the students. I have faced a difficult time, difficult roommates, weird experiences, solitude, unexpected challenges, etc. And I know I am not the only one. When I look at this group, I see diversity, not only in terms of our ethnic backgrounds, but our struggles as well. There are single parents here, second career students, students who have struggled between work and school, giving priority to one over other, and sometimes messing both up. Students who have stayed away from their hometowns, family, and friends. Students who have stayed away from their children and partners. That is very difficult. We all have struggled through the dreadfully long queues at Tim Hortons during a 10-minute break where we are rushing from one end of the college to the other just for a lecture. And many of us were lucky enough to have studied in the privileged portables. We all have worked hard through the tests, quizzes, and exams, and pardon my exaggeration, but millions of assignments that we have successfully completed to achieve all the learning outcomes of our individual programs. This is incredible, fantastic, and to go through all of this is a great achievement. I want us to remember the struggles and celebrate this day that stands for nothing less than the entire journey of each one of us. As much as we would love to take the entire credit of our achievements today, we all know, and hence, let us all be thankful to our moms and dads, family and friends, faculties, peer mentors, colleagues, managers at work, everyone who supported us and helped us to get where we are today. Struggles are never going to end. I know it's going to be very hard when life is difficult, although I can assure you that we can make it easy. All we must do is enjoy each and every moment when we are working. We all know that we all have 8 to 12 hour shifts, back pain due to uncomfortable chairs, sedentary lifestyle, robot-like schedule, and all of that coming our way. But we can do it. We need to make sure we give our 100% even when we are just a fresher. Be helpful and giving and supportive of the people around us. Or as Oprah Winfrey would say, find a way to serve. Actually, we don't need to find it. I mean, it's right in front of us. It's amongst us. Out of this graduating group, there will be professionals helping people with special needs get some mechanical support or therapy. Lab technicians testing the quality of food, drugs, and related products, making sure the community eats and stays safe. There are professionals like pharmacy assistants serving the community with dispensing right medications and drugs. Professionals working in privacy, working as data analysts, medical coders, making a difference in public health. There are experts here who will take care of the aesthetic needs of people, health, and fitness of the community. There are creative people here who will work towards bringing revolution with visual communication. There are professionals who will work very hard behind conservation of art, culture, and some markers of past. That is all service. That is us. It all depends on the way we see it. In the next phase of our lives, we will have an opportunity, a way to make a difference in the community. And along with that, a way of making our lives better, a little easier. There is a quote that has been a guiding force in my life and that has been a basis for my thoughts today. It is from Mahatma Gandhi, who said, live as if you were to die tomorrow. Learn as if you were to live forever. Everybody is different. Each one of us has a journey of our own. Each one of us has a purpose to fulfill. And let me assure you, the knowledge we have gained here on this campus is never going to be wasted. Education will help us serve. And the intention of giving it back to the world and serving will make the next phase of our lives more interesting, rewarding, and sweet. What we have achieved today is great, and if we are educated, empowered, passionate, and prepared, what is coming is going to be even better. Once again, congratulations to all the graduates. We deserve to give ourselves a huge round of applause. Thank you.
I had the privilege of meeting Darwin's mom and dad last night. They had just arrived from India. Mom and dad, you must feel so proud. And now, graduating students, I would like to call upon President Maureen Adamson and Registrar Susan Klusterman to come to the podium for the formal conferral of diplomas and certificates. Graduating students, please rise.
Madam President, it is my privilege to report to you that the candidates here assembled and those not present have qualified in all respects for diplomas or certificates by successfully completing curricula offered by Sir Sanford Fleming College. The faculty have recommended that they be awarded diplomas or certificates in recognition of their academic accomplishments.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the Board of Governors of Sir Sanford Fleming College, I do hereby confer on you your respective diploma or certificate with all the honors, privileges, and responsibilities pertaining thereto.
Please be seated.
I would now ask that our graduate name announcer, Ashvin Mahindra, to come forward to begin the presentation of college diplomas and certificates.
Madam President, I have the honor of presenting the graduates of the Biotechnology Advanced Program, accompanied by myself, the program coordinator. Come on up. Matthew Adams. Yeah. Damika Allen. Lynette Andrews. Chirag Antala. Sarah Antonucci. Devon A. Bennett. Shay Bentley. Osowo Aim Bison. Aiden Campbell. Elizabeth Cartledge. Marley Kobachuk. Sakshi Choikandi. Neil Tejas Dave. Rajpinder Dami. Sarah Donald. Brenna Farron. Shailene Gregory. Tina Hart. Shannon Hockley. Emily Hoover. Megan Hopkins. Amber Karnick. Isaac Karunaharan. Jasleen Kaur. Jaspreet Kaur. Alicia LaBelle. Amy Lappin. Yui Lee. Nathan McFarland. Natalie Mutsarona. Veronica Owens. Rajvi Pandya. Tori Paris. Binal Patel. Hani Patel. Vishaka Patel. Star Perry. Darren Pohl. Chetan Prajapati. Benny Prem. Megan Quaid. Emma Reed. Jarrett Reed. Calvin Riley. Hope Riley. Kaylee Rose. Martin Sidor. Linda Smith. Jatin Solanki. Michelle Taylor. Ashleisha Thacker. Zach Toms. Cho Tran. Shannon West. Rekha Choudhury. And those are the graduates of the Biotechnology Advanced Program. Madam President, I now have the honor of presenting the graduates of the Esthetician Program, accompanied by their program coordinator, Tracy Partridge. Bailey Agnew. Jesse Griffin. Casey Hislop. Cassandra Huffman. Stephanie Hutchison. Tyler Johnson. Morgan Kirk. Morgan Miller. Charmaine Ramo. Allison Scully. Shannon Simmons. Don Walker. Caitlin Wildman. And those are the graduates of this year's Esthetician Program. I now have the honor of presenting the graduates from the Fitness and Health Promotion Program, accompanied by their program coordinator, Alex Smith. Thomas Aaron. Jerry Brar. Gregory Burnett. Brianna Chinner. Ekta Mohit Kumar Darji. Rachel Dyer. Paulina Gomez. Kyle Graham. Harkinwal Preet. Kayla Judson Fensom. Jyoti. Kuljeet Kaur. Mackenzie Massey. Ved Prakash Patel. Vrunda Patel. Melissa Peedy. Kira Reed. Jessica Sabarin. Margaret South. Emily Stevenson. Chelsea Tinney. And those are the graduates of the Fitness and Health Promotion Program. Madam President, I now have the honor of presenting the graduates from the Health Information Management Program, accompanied by their program coordinator, Patricia Hughes. Ramaya Bandura. Maria Barrientos. Kendra Fowler. Christine Grenell. Harshit Gudapati. Sabrina Hall. Sadhana Jitta. Chloe Johnson. Giridhar Juva. Deep Kapadia. Sarah Mandarano. Lena Moses. Sai Norella. Dharav Pandya. Karthikayan Palraj. Vishwash Pair. Nirmal Ravi. Stella Sheik. Jaya Singuluri. Akansha Vakaria. Sati Venigala. Shlok Vyas. And those are the graduates of the Health Information Management Program. Madam President, I now have the honor of announcing the graduates from the Occupational Therapist Assistant and Physiotherapist Assistant Program, accompanied by their program coordinator, Kelly McKnight. Laura Adair. Rachel Biddle. Kirsten Burns. Kristen Chartrand. Wayang Choi. Taylor Cote. Tao Do. Dominique Douglas. Catherine Fairburn. Sarah Gross. Jordan Hopkinson. Madison Hines. Holland Jans. Shannon Krzyzewski. Jade Langford. Tegan Moores. Divya Patel. Jonki Patel. Jill Patel. Taylor Pruel. Nicole Rokiki. Cassandra Smith. Emma Steele. Catherine Sutton. Hang Tran. Holly Webb. And those are the graduates of the Physiotherapy Assistant and Occupational Therapy Assistant program. Madam President, I now have the honor of presenting the graduates from the Pharmacy Technician program, accompanied by their program coordinator, Amanda Mashinsky. Caitlin Baruta. Dimitri Botuk. Lisa Boucher. Madeline Daly. Angela Emerton. Devonna Gallant. Mallory Gamble. Tia Kittle. Amanda Marshall. Priyanka Mistry. Rhea Patel. Megan Scattergood. Ivory Toms. And those are the graduates of the Pharmacy Technician program. Madam President, I now have the honor of presenting the graduates of the Rec and Leisure Services program, accompanied by their program coordinator, Alex Smith. Leah Chamberlain. Megan Feely. Abby Harper. Brianna Kerr. Tanya McDermott. Riley Richmond. Vanessa Rung. Montana Sinclair Carr. Adriana Story. Morgan Taylor. Susan Weaver. And those are the graduates of the Rec and Leisure Services program. I now have the honor of presenting the graduates of the Rec and Leisure Services Accelerated program. Tammy Battelle. Raj Benara. Jacob Slater. Hannah Woods. And those are the graduates of the Rec and Leisure Services Accelerated program. Madam President, I now have the honor of presenting the graduates of the Therapeutic Recreation Program, accompanied by their program coordinator, Mark Perelin. Lindsay Aitken. Pooja Anada. Margaret Camp. Dana Carlson. Jonathan Evans. Hamda Rashid. Anita Ravindran. Shasta Tahir. Morgan Watson. And those are the graduates of the Therapeutic Recreation Program. Madam President, I now have the honor of presenting the graduates of the Cultural Heritage Conservation and Management Program, accompanied by their program coordinator, Gail McIntyre. Melanie Bell. Sarah Cousins. Amber Favreau. Joshua Forth. Brianna Ippolito. Samuel Johnson. Chelsea McConkie. Caitlin McMullen. And those are the graduates of the Cultural Heritage Conservation and Management Program. Madam President, I now have the honor of presenting the graduates of the Museum Management and Curatorship Program. Jackson Baker. Damian Coles. Alisa Dulmont. Amanda Gallagher. Tegan Goldsmith. Kira Killen. Peter McKenzie. Lisa Oversby. Holly Peterson. Megan Poxon. Brendan Raw. Caitlin Reynolds. Hannah Richardson. Sharifa Riley. Svenja Scherer. Grant Smith. Kirsten Smith. Emily Taylor. Adam Yurnick. Shoshana Watson. And those are the graduates of the Museum Management and Curatorship Program. Madam President, I have the honor of presenting the first graduates of our Graphic Design and Visual Communications program, accompanied by their program coordinator, Aneta Matsuviks.
Yay, it's our first one. Thank you.
Alicia Craig. Rachel Dyke. Leanne Kotcha. Neelam Patel. Sabrina Russell. And those are the graduates of the Graphic Design Visual Communication Program.
Sorry about that. I was just enjoying sitting down for a second. So I'm here to say that we've come to the end of our convocation, and I do have a couple of remarks at the end of this. But before we close, I just want to remind folks that to ask all guests to please remain in your seats until the platform guests have left the stage. Our graduates will then follow the platform guests, and family and friends can then follow the rest of the way out. And everyone is welcome, and we hope that you will come over to the main campus building for a reception in the Kawartha Trades and Technology Center. I do want to once again acknowledge the hard work and tremendous efforts of each and every one of our graduates have made here today. It's an amazing place for you to be in life. I also want to thank again the folks that have been involved in today's convocation, and a special thanks to our board member, Mike Leonard, who was here to bring greetings and bestow the diplomas on graduates, as well as our other board member, Nicole Grady, for assisting. Ashley Safar for the amazing Indigenous tribute to the graduates, and again to the staff of the Registrar's Office and all of those who you know have been involved in this very important event. To all of the academic award winners from last night's ceremonies, thank you for everything you do, and congratulations to you for all of your commitment to your studies and to your place in our future. So I'd like to just ask one big round of applause for all of these folks. So there are a few things that come with being a president that are a privilege, and I get to make a couple of closing remarks, which I would like to do. So graduates, I would just say, never forget who helped you along the way, and always think of who you will help. Your education is an important part of your arsenal, but never forget the relationships that you have developed along the way. And graduates, always remember, you do you. Congratulations.